You know, when you have a neighbor like the Atlantic Ocean, it gives some and it takes some.
If it's happened once like this, and it was devastating, what happens next?
How do we make ourselves resilient? What are the impacts that we can anticipate and plan for?
We not only play and exhibit and so forth in these spaces, we live here. This is damage that happened throughout all of our communities here.
You know, there's no silver bullet, and each area and each solution is a little bit different. So you take broad brushes approach to it, but what you're doing, especially when it's your house or your beach, becomes very personal.
It is very much our neighbor. It is not a distant park. So you do have a very personal community connection to it.
Hurricane Sandy was really a game changer here. It turned the idea of climate change from something that was a theoretical concept to a real part of our everyday lives.
We're sitting at the end of Shore Road, which was a concrete road of about a mile that the Army used to service its munitions and things here at the park before, obviously, was a national park. After Hurricane Sandy, we lost about a half of the road. People love to use the walkway here. Which part of it needs to be preserved, and how sustainable can we make that?
We had the hurricane come through and take out an existing dune system. In the process, it created piping plover habitat, a federally endangered species. Protecting these things may call for very different and competing measures. Do we replace the dune? Do we leave the habitat be? And then looking at the recreational access to the shoreline there too, and what's best for the visitor. Then you compound that with looking at this in the broader context of, well, what does this mean to the community directly adjacent to the park border there? And how do we take into account the safety of the community with future storm events and with sea level rise? It is not if, it is when the next big storm event happens. And so everything we're doing, we look at through the filter of resilience. And are we investing our money and making decisions that are preparing us for that next event? So we need to focus the resources we have on where they can make the most difference.
This is great. I mean, you kind of get almost like a vacation or a recreational type setting in, you know, in such a urbanized area.
Fort Tilden especially is considered an urban park by definition. It is more in the community considered our park.
People come here many times in their lifetimes. This may be their Yosemite. This is their Everglades.
Focus, baby, focus.
Kids coming from, you know, Brooklyn and stuff like that, but they can come right across the bridge, you know, take a bus ride across the bridge and enjoy what Fort Tilden, you know, recreational facilities have to offer.
In a place like New York City, where we've got, you know, 8 to 10 million people right directly around the park with easy access and in a major media market with high visibility, and facing the issues of climate change, I mean, we're perfectly positioned to really be a showcase park. And so that's really the opportunity we're looking to seize, and not just to build better, but to help educate and spread these ideas of what people can do on their own as well.
Whether you use the term climate change or not, where's the downside of taking care of what is all around us?